Good morning, everyone. Chief Justice of the Iowa Supreme Court, Mark Cady, is with us today, as you heard. Justice Cady, thanks for being with us.
Well, thank you, Kevin. Thanks for inviting me.
You bet. And a lot of things that I'd love to talk about, because it was just a couple of weeks ago that you went before the Iowa legislature and you talked about the importance of the Judiciary Committee, the judiciary system, the traditional state of the judiciary. And one of the things that you talked about I thought was very interesting and might be a good place to start off, and that was the economic prosperity, as you put it, the effect of the judiciary system on Iowa's economy. We talked about taxes and tourism helping Iowa's economic development, but I must say I think this is the first time I've ever heard the judiciary put in that same category.
Well, I think it's a message that fits certainly with the conversation of today, but it's important to talk about our courts and look at the value that they provide in a broad way. And one thing that courts have always done is allow a state or an entity to prosper through the stability that courts provide. And that's been one of our main functions throughout our history.
How does it do that?
Well, businesses need rules of the game that are going to be applied in a fair and impartial way. And when a court system can be set up to provide that, then that builds the confidence that is needed for people to invest into a state, to want to come into a state and build a factory, when there's courts there to protect that through an application of rules of law.
And you were saying this actually goes back to the very beginning of the state.
Well, it really does. It's amazing. I was reading the Constitutional Convention, and this concept was mentioned back then by our forefathers.
Well, let's talk about the state of the judiciary, since that's the address that you give every year before the joint session. What is the state of Iowa's judiciary overall?
Well, it's kind of two approaches. On one hand, we have the best people working in our court system that Iowa could expect, but just top-notch people, and consequently, we're running a very efficient and good court system. On the other hand, we're threatened. We're threatened because our funding is becoming less and less and less, and we're having to place more and more of the burden on the backs of our employees, and we are starting to see that we're not providing Iowans the services that they deserve and need.
I was going to say, I do want to talk more about the budget, because I know that is one of the main things that concerns you. But one of the reasons that the budget has happened, or that the budget crisis has happened, you indicated, is because the judicial system is doing so much. And one of the areas that struck me in the address, you talked about drug courts. And I suspect that 20 years ago, there weren't too many drug courts. It's just indicative of how society has changed. But the court system has had to adjust to that, too. There are now more than 20 of these special drug courts.
Yeah, we currently have 27 drug courts in Iowa, and the purpose is to identify not just the problem, but to solve the problem so that people don't keep coming back into our court system. Our statistics show that for every person that we can keep out of our adult prison system, that over the lifetime of that person, we save the state $2 million. And so if we can really focus the attention on the needs of that individual, we not only save that individual and that family, but we allow someone to go on with a prosperous life. And these work. Drug courts work.
And that also brings up juvenile court when you talk about, you know, catching the problem early.
That's exactly right. Our courts serve our kids. That's one of our main missions. And what's really difficult right now is we know that in some instances we are not doing the job that we know we need to be doing. We don't have the funds, we don't have the time, we don't have the resources, and that's why I'm really trying to focus on getting attention to getting us a little more money. We don't need a lot more, we just need a little more money, but that money will go a long ways.
We're going to talk about money issues in just a moment. Our time is up for this segment, Justice Cady, but we will be back with Chief Justice Mark Cady right after this.